Hi, this is Dave Vellante, and we're back live at VMworld 2011. And this is SiliconANGLE's continuous coverage of theCUBE VMworld 2011. I'm Dave Vellante with Wikibon.org. I'm here with Fergal O'Sullivan from NYSE Euronext, And we're really excited, Fergal, to have you on. Right. This is a great story that we're going to tell. Really talking about how, you know, this whole, it underscores how this business is changing.
Absolutely.
You think of NYSE, you know, and you know, this institution becoming essentially a cloud service provider. So let's start with, so you're head of platform development,
yeah.
Vice President of Platform Development at NYSE. What's your role there, and set up what you guys are doing with this really innovative program?
Sure. Well, as you said, Dave, probably about 10 years ago, most of the trading that was going on in the New York Stock Exchange was done manually with tickets. You know, if you've seen the movie Trading Places, guys would be there throwing paper around. But over the last 10 years, it really has been a very dynamic shift to electronic trading. And the NYSE has had to really make a lot of changes to adapt to that and to really help our clients. So what we've been doing now is sort of building on a history of moving into very high-end data centers. We built two major data centers, one in New Jersey, one actually in London, just outside London. And we've moved our matching engines where the trades get done into these data centers. We've connected all of them on a very high-speed wide area network. And then we've provided clients basically with the ability to, you know, deploy their own systems in these data centers. And that really brought us up to about a couple of months ago. My job has been over the past 9 months to help develop a cloud infrastructure in those data centers as well, so that we're now able to say to clients, rather than you deploying servers and you deploying systems, we can actually already have those platforms deployed, up and running, available in these data centers, which are very high-end data centers. I mean, very, you know, security, reliability, and so on. You know, for more of a pay-as-you-go, month-to-month model, where there's an operating expense rather than a capital expense, you can actually start to leverage the top stuff that the real high-end trading firms use already.
Okay, so now, if I understand it correctly, that's something that you guys were doing internally. Is that right?
Well, absolutely. We used to do it internally ourselves. We've been moving all of our applications into the cloud over the past number of years.
And then the light bulb went off and somebody said, hey, we can actually make a business out of this
and
monetize it.
It's exactly.
Very Amazon-like in a way.
Yeah,
right?
And what's interesting is it's a real service that our clients need, because the cost of doing electronic trading has just been skyrocketing, you know, with these very high-end firms buying faster and faster computers, deploying closer and closer to where the trading gets done. And so some of the smaller guys would have been struggling to keep up. And now we're basically providing them with a platform that can give them, you know, almost equal performance, you know, for a fraction of the cost.
Yeah, we had a stat on earlier in one of the spotlights. There was a quote from a gentleman at Goldman Sachs saying that it was an infinitesimally short amount of time, mm-hmm. for every whatever microsecond we shave off of a transaction time, it's $100 million a year.
Yeah,
you know,
that's a pretty good statistic.
That was
mind-boggling.
How do I get some of that? Yeah, how do you get some of that?
Speed
in real time is everything in your world.
Well, it really is. I mean, we measure almost everything is measured in microseconds. Many of our pieces are now being measured in nanoseconds. So, you know, if you know Star Trek, they were, you know, into nano this, nano that. It really is a whole new level of performance and reliability that the financial services firms need. And we're giving them, you know, that type of capability more in an on-demand, in a compute-on-demand environment now.
Now, we just had Prasad Rampali on and Mark Lesher, and they were talking about the types of services that they're trying to deploy. You know what they do, right? That's the solutions group. They prove it out.
Absolutely.
And they said, we're working toward analytics as a service, as a solution, and that's really what you're doing.
Correct.
Right? So you're sort of the first instantiation of that solution.
Yeah.
So the focus is on analytics. Talk a little bit more about that.
Okay, so basically the way it typically gets done is that people are doing low latency trading, and that's involving basically quoting, and then when there's a match, they get a strike and they get an actual trade. But they need to, before they run these actual applications that are doing all this electronically, they really need to test them very heavily. They need to figure out, do I have the right strategy? Am I analyzing the incoming data stream? Am I finding opportunities? Am I seeing trends? And what that requires is access to huge volumes of data. So that's sort of the big data. I mean, typically, you know, as an example, just to capture one day's worth of U.S. equities and options today is probably about 200 gigabytes of storage. So, you know, it's a terabyte a day, it's 50 terabytes a year. It's growing exponentially. We're basically providing them now with an infrastructure to sort of start to access that historical data. They can then run simulations, they can analyze it, they can see trends, they can find opportunities, and then when they feel like they've really got it, and, you know, they can run all that in the cloud, and then they might take it and take the low latency piece and run it on a physical machine, but they've got the actual, all the back testing and the reporting when it's done. Did I hit my goals and did I hit my targets, which is obviously important too.
Yeah, so where are you at? When are you actually going to launch the service and start, you know, signing up customers?
Yeah, well, we did a soft launch already, July 1st, so we have a number of clients very heavily testing. They're now validating that their applications work. It's really a little bit complicated. We have a very high level of security in our deployment model. We have high requirements for market data, which is, you know, coming down, as I mentioned, literally millions of updates per second. So our clients are testing their applications, and we expect in the next few weeks to have two or three clients actually running production in our cloud.
What's EMC doing in all this? Is they're a vendor, obviously.
Absolutely.
Is it more than that? Or?
Well, yeah, both VMware and EMC have been our joint partners on the launch of this cloud. We've had a great experience with both firms. VMware obviously providing the vCloud Director and the virtualization layer. EMC providing the VNX storage platform. And we actually have, we're just about to launch, and maybe this is a little preview. Pretty soon we'll be doing a press release on a cloud advisory service, which we're working with EMC Consulting on, and we really think this is going to be something very, very valuable. We'll basically be able to walk into a client who's struggling with the debate about what can and can't run in a cloud, and, you know, what is valuable about the NYSC platform, and what could they move in there. And we'll be able to do a consulting engagement where we analyze all these applications, and we basically will put them through a filter to see, are they suitable, you know, from a functionality perspective, from a trust and security perspective, and from a cost perspective. And then we'll literally give a report that you could go to your board with and say, you know, here are the applications we should put on
that,
on the
That's
the
an interesting
platform.
Service. So let's talk about that a little bit. What are the dimensions that you're looking at? I mean, you guys went through this yourselves to figure out what's appropriate and applicable for the cloud. So you're drawing on that knowledge. What are the dimensions that you're looking at? I mean, obviously, there's got to be, you know, there's cost, but there's got to be value dimensions, risk. You know, give us a little
Absolutely.
Color.
I mean, I suppose there the initial thing is there are a bunch of filters, like does this, if I moved my application into the capital markets community platform, will it behave and will it have the features it needs to work, right? So that's a pretty straightforward one. And, you know, there's front office, middle office, and back office applications, and each of them need different requirements. So some of them are suitable today. Some of them we might need to add some features.
What's an example of a feature that would be, you know, critical?
So, you know, the access to real-time market data, right? Is that, you know, that's an obvious one. We clearly do it.
Yeah.
But other ones might be, let's say, web streaming quotes to a million possible simultaneous users over the internet. Well, we don't actually have internet connection into our data center intentionally, because that's a major security risk, right? Now, you can get the internet there, but we wouldn't really recommend that, for example, as a real use case for the community platform today.
Better places to put that.
There's better places to put that. So we would put it through a functionality filter first. Then we want to go through the trust one, which is, okay, if I put my customer information there, if I put my proprietary trading strategies there, could somebody else access that and understand what I'm doing, which I wouldn't really want. And, you know, there's an area where NYSE is in a, Euronext is in a very strong position, because we're basically applying the same very high level of standards to security that we apply to our own markets. So that really is a big strength that we have there. But it does mean some limitations in functionality, because, you know, to really secure it, it also means, you know, you have an extra lock on the door, right? And then the last one is the cost. Does it make sense? Is it cheaper to run it in our platform or not? And we basically will kick out very honest results. The EMC team did a full analysis of our platform, and they'll come back out and say, you know, these five applications are ideal today, and these five will be tomorrow.
So it's a for-pay service, correct?
Absolutely.
Good, because if it weren't for pay, then nobody's got any skin in the game.
It wouldn't be worth it.
It just doesn't happen.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm always leery of these sort of lost leaders that...
Yeah. No, this is...
That's just pure marketing, whereas
correct.
If an executive is writing a check, you know, they have a real need.
Correct. And this is a report that you can go to the board with, you know, and you can and they'll read it, they'll understand it, and they'll see the value proposition that we're offering.
Fascinating. We're talking to NYSE, a very interesting case study. Now, how are you going to measure the success of this? I mean, obviously there's a top line, but can you share with us some of your primary objectives and measurements around
initiative? I mean, we really see this as very transformative. The industry has obviously gone through some major trauma over the last 3 or 4 years. Clients are really looking to obviously cut costs and find new ways of generating revenue. The infrastructure and the plumbing has become so cost prohibitive that clients really want to get a shared infrastructure. So to us, success is actually enabling firms that weren't able to compete at the high end, and now they can because there's an entry level that's a lot lower than it used to be. And I think it's almost a democratization again, a re-democratization, however you want to put it. We're building a community, we're bringing clients in, we're bringing vendors in, we're bringing third parties in, and there's going to be a vibrant environment for financial services firms in the capital markets to use this platform.
It's really going to shake things up. I mean, you know, you think of financial services, you think of always a leader in technology adoption.
Absolutely.
You know, one of the industries that will clearly tell you, CIOs and financial services, I'm going to talk about this publicly because this is a competitive advantage for us. Mm-hmm. And now you're saying you're bringing to the small guys the capabilities that only the big guys had before that.
Correct.
You know, that is really game changing.
Yeah. If you want the bottom line on it as well, we have these giant data centers that are really super, you know, tier 4 guided data centers, and there's a lot of space in them, and we want to fill them with a lot of servers, and we think the capital markets community platform will generate the demand to do so. So,
I think there's no doubt. I mean, I said before it's very Amazon-like. I mean, Amazon has allowed little guys like Wikibon and SiliconANGLE to have infrastructure that is, you know, world class.
Absolutely.
Easily compete with the big guys. In fact, I would argue that our IT infrastructure is better than our larger competitors.
Yeah, I would agree.
And I think you guys are going to bring that to the capital markets, and it's going to really be fun to watch.
Change the game.
Well, Fergal O'Sullivan, it was a great story, and we'll be following it closely. Love to have you back as you roll it out in the fall and then just track your progress. Really want to see... what's happening here, how it's changing the markets, and what you guys are learning. So thanks very much for coming on theCUBE.
Well, thank you for having me.
Pleasure meeting you.
Absolutely.
All right. Great segment. We'll be right back with VMworld Live 2011, SiliconANGLE's continuous coverage.
My name is Fergal O'Sullivan, and I'm Vice President of Platform Development for NYSE Technologies. Data? Well, information is absolutely critical in the financial services industry. There really isn't much else. Everything starts with a quote. When two people want to agree on a price, they send quotes out, and that data leads to a whole chain of actions, especially when they match and we get a trade. Excellent.